two metro school districts responding tonight after one of their students is diagnosed with drug-resistant staph.
The school districts are Shawnee Mission and Piper. Tonight, the Piper School District says it has done everything possible to keep it from spreading. KMBC 9's Beth Chapman is live at the school with the latest. Beth?
Jim, members of the Piper High football team are just now leaving the parking lot back there after practice that was minus one player, a junior who last week developed what looked like a spider bite on his arm that tested positive for a dangerous form of staph. The superintendent says none of the 500-plus students here have anything to fear because the parents of the football player acted fast.
The parent alerted us, and that helped us, and that helped us help the rest of the kids.
The rest of the kids took home letters from the district late last week explaining what was going on, that people like these would be wiping down the school over the weekend, starting with this athletic building.
We basically cleaned this place from head to toe, as well as every piece of equipment and pads. We took care of this. We took care of locker rooms at the middle school, and then disinfected all hard surfaces in the school.
Schools across the country have been doing this as a precaution after a Virginia teenager diagnosed with the drug-resistant staph died last week. The football player here is reportedly recovering from the infection, but since the team uses this building...
We weren't even sure there was a connection between the facility and the staph infection, but it wasn't worth taking a chance.
Back live now. Friday was a regularly scheduled day off from classes, so the cleaning crews got to work on this right away. The football team did play a game here Friday, but they moved their locker room to a place inside the high school. The superintendent says this case has provided them an opportunity to talk to students about hygiene to prevent the spread of staph. We are live in Piper. Back to you.
Thank you, Bev. Now, as we told you earlier, a student at Shawnee Mission School, Corinth Elementary School, has been diagnosed with the antibiotic-resistant strain as well. The district sent home a letter today to parents, and this is what it says. Students diagnosed with MRSA will be allowed to come to school, providing any wounds are covered and they are being treated by a physician. Any student diagnosed with MRSA will be excluded from activities involving skin-to-skin contact in both physical education and athletics. The schools took steps to prevent the infection from possibly spreading. There are steps you can take as well to lower your family's risk. The Mayo Clinic advises the best defense is careful hand washing, and that means scrubbing your hands for at least 15 to 30 seconds. And if you're using a hand sanitizer, you should use one that contains at least 62% alcohol to kill the germs. Keep wounds covered with a bandage to prevent bacteria from spreading. Avoid sharing personal items like towels, razors, and athletic equipment. And for more information on staph infections and all this, go to KMBC.com. Just click on health.